So you've decided to digitize all of your old videotapes. Now you have to figure out what to do next. Here are some things you should be thinking about as we count down the top 5 mistakes to avoid when transferring your videotapes to digital format. Mistake number 5, digitizing your tapes straight to DVD.
Many people think the best thing to do when transferring their videotapes to digital format is to burn them to DVD. In fact, this is usually the wrong way to go. DVD is not a good archiving format and usually starts to decay after 5 years or so. The best way to preserve these precious video memories is to burn them into video files. Then these can be stored on a Mac or PC, edited using any standard video software, and then burned to a DVD to share with friends and family.
Mistake number 4, choosing the wrong format.
One of the most common mistakes people make is choosing the right format for their video files. This is confusing because there's such a wide array of video formats. Most of the big companies like Apple, Microsoft, Sony have their own proprietary video formats. So which is the right one to choose? MPEG-4 is usually the way to go. MPEG-4 is basically the video format of MP3, which is used for music. By choosing MPEG-4, you get the most flexibility in terms of the devices you can play your videos on, as well as getting the highest possible quality out of the smallest possible file size.
Mistake number 3, not backing up your videos.
Once your videotapes are transferred to video files, you need to decide how to store and preserve them. So you want to store them on your Mac or your PC, as well as back them up to a USB hard drive such as this or a home media server. This will protect them in case your computer crashes. But you also want to have an off-site storage solution as well to protect from events like a fire or flood. There's a lot of online services for backing up video content. They typically run $5 to $10 a month. So take a look at what's out there and decide what works best for you.
Mistake number 2, not sharing your videos.
A lot of people are surprised to learn how easy it is to share their classic old videotapes with friends and family. Once your videos are digitized, you can post them to sites like Facebook and YouTube. Just log into your account, upload the video content, and share.
And finally, mistake number 1, not trying out the latest video gadgets and experiences.
Once your tapes are digitized, there are tons of gadgets out there that you can use to really bring life back into your old videos. You can load them onto your iPhone or other mobile device, stream them to an Apple TV or TiVo. You can even stream them to PlayStation or Xbox. Once your videos are in MPEG-4 format, you have tons of options. So just get out there, play around, and have some fun.
Now you know what you need to do with your old videotapes. The question is, what's the easiest and most affordable way to do all this? The answer is Digitize My Life. To find out just how easy and affordable it can be, visit www.digitizemylife.net.